Hello and welcome to this Sisters of Battle painting guide. In this video, we're going to share how to paint the cream stone effect as seen on the statue from the Battle Sanctum set. Now, before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, I've used Wraithbone, which is the perfect undercoat for this colour scheme. Now, we're going to start first by applying a shade and then a contrast. The shade's going to be Seraphim Sepia, which will be thinning down quite heavily with Lamy Medium. Then after that, we'll use some Skeleton Horde, which is just going to drop into the recesses. But first of all, let's start with Seraphim Sepia. So I'm going to be using a medium shade brush here, so a bit more accuracy, it's got a nice point to it. Now I'm going to get 5 dollops, or 5 parts, of Lamy Medium. Give that a quick wash, and then I'll have 1 part of Seraphim Sepia. So it's not too neat, it's just a little bit lighter. Once I've loaded my brush up, we're then ready to start applying that to the model. Take your time, and you can see it's just staining that stone, or at least that cream, a little bit more, and just drop it into the recesses. There we are, with that thinned down Seraphim Sepia now dry. What I'm going to now do is just get some Skeleton Horde and just start running that into some of the deeper recesses. It's a bit stronger in tone, it has obviously a little bit more pigment in it as well, so it's great for just dropping into the recesses. And you've got more control if you use a small brush like I'm doing here. Just take your time, work your way all the way around. There we are, with all that Skeleton Horde now dropped into the recesses and dry. What we're going to do now is move on to doing some dry brushing. So we're going to start first by using Wraithbone, which will dry brush quite heavily over the model. Then after that, we'll be using some Pallid Witch Flesh and some White Scar, which will do a little bit lighter. But first of all, let's start with our Wraithbone. So what I'm going to do, as I always do with dry brushing, is load up my brush. Now the idea here is remove as much of that paint as possible. So you're still leaving pigments of it on the bristles. So I like to do circular motions and crisscrossing motions here. That helps remove a lot of the pigment that's actually started to fall into the bristles. So I'll just do a little bit more here. Again, get a bit more stability there on the actual tissue. And I'm just going to move to the side. There we are. There's plenty on there still, but not enough to swamp the model. So what I'm now going to do, I'm going to do something called a heavy dry brush. So normally when I do a light dry brush, I'm just hardly touching the model and moving across. But a heavy dry brush, you're putting a bit more pressure on. So you're actually stabbing in a bit more. And all I'm going to do here is just whip my way around. As you can see, it's starting to pick that Wraithbone on those raised areas. I'm going quite rapidly as well, back and forth, try and making sure I don't get any into the recesses. If you do find you get some of the dry brush pigment into the recesses, just get some Skeleton Horde and just drop it back in there again. With that first heavy dry brush now done, we're going to use some Pallid Witch Flesh and just lightly dust that over some of those raised areas, like so. Again, this is quite subtle, so it's just going to pick out like things like the tips and like the folds of the cloth and like knuckles and extremities. Don't put too much pressure on, you just want to be tickling it. And all we're going to do now is use White Scar just to dry brush on those extreme edges. And you just want to go a bit softer here, almost tickling it. There we are with that final dry brush now done. The cream stone of the statue from the Battle Sanctum set is now done. Now remember, by following the methods and techniques in this guide, you can easily apply this to other white or cream stone within your collections. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own cream stone, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.